Now we're going to talk about why positional number system such as Arabic number system is so powerful that it can eventually take over the world. If I were to use the familiar Arabic numerals, I won't be able to see the nature of positional number system as clear. For example, I will read out loud 52,093. But if I were to use the unfamiliar set of symbols, then it gets me to think it's essentially a combination problem. A classical problem in school asking you how many different combinations you can make by using 10 color balls. Problem I didn't care about before. Once you see the number making process as a basic symbol combination problem, you will understand why it's powerful. And also understand its difficulty. It must be difficult. Otherwise, Romans would have invented it, right? It's powerful because it only requires a few basic symbols. Then through permutation, you can form an enormous number of patterns. So here we have 10 basic symbols. How many different combinations you can have if you're allowed to pick 5 symbols? Most of us would know that each box can have 10 choices. When these 10 places are ticking together, from those 10 choices, we have 10 to the power of 5 different symbols, which has almost 100,000 combinations. If you add one more position, you will have 10 times the potential. It's difficult because, yes, it has huge potential. But how would you be able to unlock its potential? How can you use them as numbers? How would you assign orders to them? For example, here are the possible combinations. But which one represents 1, 2, 3, and 4? These symbols might look weird. But do you realize that they're just names for different quantities, right? So essentially, we need to have a method to assign names to different quantities. Speaking of names, why do we give people different names in the first place? Well, this way we can communicate with each other. We can gossip about other people when they are not around. So the number-making process is really about naming the quantities. How do we make names for people? We arrange letters. But because we also need to speak those names, we only use the combinations that are easy to pronounce. For example, we wouldn't call them OTM, MTO, MMO, or OOO. Not only that, we assign names randomly. There are no reasons why we name someone either Tom or Jeff. But then how will we know who's who whenever the name pops up? Unfortunately, we will have to memorize this. Studies show that, on average, people deal with only 100 to 300 people in their social relationships. So memorizing a few hundred names probably isn't that bad. But if we randomly name quantities, then we will have to memorize what they mean. That's impossible, because there could be an infinite quantities out there. There is no way we can memorize this infinite number of names. The purpose of having names for those quantities is, whenever we see the symbol, we will know what they represent. This many, for this many. It can also work in the other way. For this many quantity, what is the name for that? This guy or this guy? So, unlike regular names which are random, these names for different quantities have to follow a certain order. That is, they have to be predictable. In order to come up with predictable names for quantities, we would only consider a fixed set of basic symbols that we can arrange. There are many ways to arrange these 3 symbols. If you are not organized in arranging them, you will end up with random symbols. If you assign these random symbols to different quantities, unless you memorize such map in your head, otherwise you will be confused what they represent. We need an ordered way of arranging symbols and assign names to quantities. Each of these positions can flip among those symbols. So you want to establish an order when flipping them, so that there won't be any miss or duplicates. So here we agree to switch according to this sequence TOM. You start with one position each time, right to left. You can start with any symbol, say we start with M. But you need to make sure you're flipping the symbols according to the order here, so from M to O. Then you move on to the next position. Say we flip from O to T. Now each symbol can be combined with the 3 symbols previously to form 3 new combos. flipping through the list, forming another two groups. Each one is going to produce three now, so we end up with nine combos. Now move on to the third position, from T to M. Each one symbol combines with nine symbols now, forming nine combos. Pick another one, forming another nine, pick another one, forming another nine. So we end up with 27 symbols. If we append one more symbol, we can triple the symbol list. If we assign these order names to increasing quantities from 1 and onward, then we can derive what quantity a particular name represents if we know two things. First of all, the starting symbol representing 1, and the symbol flipping sequence used to crunch those names. For example, given the particular symbol TOT, since the first position differs by 1 switching, this 1 switching represents a quantity of 1. So the difference between these two symbols will be 1. We can therefore derive that the symbol of TOT represents 2. Of course, if the first position differs by 2 switching, it will represent a quantity of 3. So the nice thing about this ordered way of crunching symbols and naming quantity is, each symbol switching can tell us something about the quantity it represents. Of course, these two examples are very simple. We need to figure out what quantity a typical name like this represents. It would involve symbol switching across all locations. We need to know what quantity each switching represents. These are the place values at the heart of positional number system. These place values are critical to help us back out what a quantity a particular symbol represents, so that we can derive their meanings without the need to memorize much. In the next section, we're going to see that.